Good evening to everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, Asta, you are audible.
Okay, so good evening to the respective jury members and the chairperson. Today, my poster's topic is the art of war of victims. Every now and then, we have discussed about the crime and the criminal profiling and how does forensic psychology deals with the criminals. But how does forensic psychology or the particular psychology deals with victims, how victims take it up and how they cope up, there is a difference. And they fight a war within themselves and for themselves to overcome their traumas. So the victim faces different challenges. The shock of being victimized, dealing with the police and the courts every now and then, even after the crime. The reaction of others returning to the normal life is difficult for them. And also they feel very insecure, self-blame, and they self-blame themselves for being the victim in a particular crime. So it has been also noted that victims don't seem to return to the pre-crime levels of stress, although they manage to function relatively well. Victimization appears to have long-term effects on everyone. Victims of crime continue to deal with the same family relationship and life stress as all individuals, but the stress of being a crime victim is piled on top of the stressors. Now, there are common coping strategies that are taken up by victims. And that depends on individual to individual. Some take up the positive coping strategies and some take up the negative coping strategies. As you can see in my poster, I have mentioned few of the positive coping strategies and few of the negative coping strategies. So I'll explain all this in detail. So the positive strategies include information seeking, positive thinking, activism, time to heal, support and growth, emotional control, social comparison, etc. And negative strategies include behavioral avoidance, pessimistic, ignorance, insecurity, self-harm, crime obsession, and self-deception. So let's have a look at the positive strategies. First, seeking information. So victims, when take up the positive coping strategies, in particularly seeking information, they often require information which include details of the justice system, program options and common reactions. Gathering such information helps them make their decision based on what treatment they would like to have or what would the help they would want to have in the future. Next is a positive thinking, that is being optimistic. They self-compare themselves. Research on sexual assault victims show that some victims feel better by focusing on how they are now survivors. It also shows that victims may initially embrace themselves, as it shows that the assault was not their fault. They switch to the survivor because it reflects strength, recovery, and being a fighter. When dealing with tough situations, people often need to make sense of what happened and then search for some personal benefit. Next point is a social comparison, in which victims often compare themselves to other victims that have faced the similar crimes and how they are dealing with the particular crime and how they are making up in their lives. The next point is activities for regaining control. Victims can also do things that make them feel more in control of their life. For example, the victims of assault might take up self-defense class. Activism is that victims who want to make social awareness, they become advocates or activists so that they can use their experience and make a better society on the social level. The next is the emotional control. This involves the activities that try to directly change how the victim feels. The emotional control activities can be referred to as relaxation, meditation, positive thinking, being optimistic, and further. Growth and support. Natural and professional support helps victims. Both are equally important. Victims benefit from talking to other people about their experiences and feelings. Supportive people provide information, companionship, reality checks, and emotional support to the victims. Now, many of us would say that the negative coping strategies may not help the individuals as much as the positive strategies help, but this we can consider as a myth because negative coping strategies also helps the individual to regain and to rebuild his or her life. First, behavioral avoidance. This may be reflected as not leaving one's apartment or avoiding therapists, but the research suggests that avoidance is at best a band-aid solution. and at worst, it may even be ineffective and harmful. In many cases, initial avoidance of challenging situations may help victims slowly build on small success. This allows victims to take time to heal, to understand what they have been through, and to gather resources to rebuild their lives. The other coping, negative coping strategy is denial or self-deception. This helps the victim to temporarily erase the memories. Active blocking of memories and feelings help to cope with overwhelming emotions. They lessen the initial stress that the victim faces. The other is the dissociation. It is a clinical, what is dissociation? So dissociation is a clinical term that means that there is break in a person's normal way of thinking, memory, identity, or how he or she sees his or her environment. People with a history of frequent and severe traumatic experiences seem more commonly to use this to cope up. The other is substance misuse. Now, this may not be helpful in the long run, but people consider this as a coping strategy that they use alcohol or drugs to often cope up themselves to or to often forget what they have been through. The other is a self-harm. One often hears of people engaging in physical self-harm, such as cutting or burning themselves. There is an argument that self-destructive behavior, such as prostitution, substance abuse, eating disorders, and so forth, also fall under this category of deliberate self-harm. In conclusion, I would like to say that all the victims have their war to fight within themselves, and they try different levels so that they can deal and rebuild their lives. So we as their family members or as their professional colleagues should support any victim who has been through anything in the best way they find it to heal. Thank you. That was all about my post.